There's no other fellowship that really targets the STEM population, which doesn't typically find a home when it comes to public policy, but they do have the raw technical and quantitative background to both think through and action on policy change once they're given the right framework. And that's exactly what this fellowship is about doing, is giving them the academic opportunity to take the coursework to learn how to leverage those skills. But at the same time, we're investing in 9 months of immersive learning for those fellows, where they will engage with research centers that both work on the policy assessment side, but also on reshaping policy itself.
Well, I think if you want to make a difference in the world, even if you're coming from a technical field, you need to understand the Harris School way. What that means is understanding how to do rigorous research and how to understand the results that you get.
This is a program which is going to teach them how they can do that and then give them real opportunities to do so in meaningful settings.
It's an 11-month program, the first quarter of which will be coursework. They're then going to take that core and they're going to immediately apply it starting in the fall quarter. It's effectively an opportunity for them to engage in purpose-driven consulting with research centers, both at the University of Chicago and in the city writ large.
Some of the organizations that the students might get to work with are the Crime and Education Lab, the Mansueto Institute on Urban Innovation and their really important work on tax equity or their work supporting data journalism, the Behavioral Insights in Parenting Lab and their work developing ed tech and other kinds of solutions to help disadvantaged families.
One project that a social impact fellow could work on in our lab is a technology-based tool we've developed called Chat to Learn that fosters children's language development and curiosity. That social impact fellow is going to be involved in helping us on the back end development, but also helping us interpret how do parents and teachers think about this? How can we design the tool for use in the real world so that we get the evidence we need so that we can make policy relevant recommendations both for families and for schools?
We think that one critical aspect of the fellowship program will be an opportunity for the fellows to reconvene in an annual retreat where they come back to the University of Chicago, see how the work that they did reshaped the organization and had a policy impact. It also gives them an opportunity to engage with future generations of the fellowship program. In the long run, our aim really is to generate the next generation of impact leaders. Finishing undergrad and making this often difficult choice about the future really does bind on how can I even do this practically. We want to make that difficult choice as easy as possible. And that's because this program comes with an extraordinarily generous stipend. And the hope ultimately is that that enables us to identify, recruit, retain, and support the most talented young people that we can find every year to join that fellowship program. It's an opportunity for you to try on a different future, have impact while being supported financially. And of course, at the end, it's not all about the finances, and it's not just about working with those clients. It's about the fact that when our fellows leave, they leave with a credential that certifies the coursework that they took here at the university and ultimately make them more successful, both at the first place where they end up, but in the long run as well.